Dear students, very pleasant good morning to all of you. Today we are going to discuss the fourth unit of environmental studies for degree courses. This first and second semester, and the fourth unit is environmental issues, policies and practices. As you all know about the environment, what is environment, what are the components of the environment. Now in this unit we are going to discuss the issues of the environment, what are the problems are being faced by the environment nowadays, what are the role of the human being for creating such problems, what the human being was not supposed to do, and what are the mistakes, what are the violations human being has made for creating these issues or environmental issues. Is environment in historical time, if you must have heard, environment was very clean, means it was possessing a clean air, clean water, uncontaminated soil, no noise pollution, no radioactive pollution, and so many other problems. But nowadays environment is challenged by number of problems, and all the environment, all the problems which are being faced by the environment nowadays can collectively be categorized as environmental issues. Means wo sare problems जो एनवायरनमेंट आज के डेट में फेस कर रहा है, किसी भी प्रॉब्लम के फॉर्म में, चाहे वो आपका एयर पोल्यूशन है, वो चाहे वाटर पोल्यूशन हो, चाहे सॉइल पोल्यूशन हो, नॉइस पोल्यूशन हो, वेस्ट पोल्यूशन हो, सॉलिड वेस्ट पोल्यूशन हो, ओजोन लेयर डिप्लेशन की बात करते हैं, क्लाइमेट चेंज की बात करते हैं, बायोलॉजिकल डाइवर्सिटी लॉस की बात करते हैं, इंक्रीज इन ग्रीन हाउस गैस की बात करते हैं, या नेचुरल डिजास्टर्स की बात करते हैं, तो ये सब कलेक्टिवली क्या है, एनवायरमेंटल इश्यूज है. देन व्हाट आर द पॉलिसीज, पॉलिसीज मींस व्हाट आर द मेजर्स द रेस्पेक्टिव गवर्नमेंट इज टेकिंग to tackle such problems. Means what are the policies already framed or is framing as per the arise of the problem to tackle such menaces or such problems by the concerned government, be it at a community level, block level, district level, state level, national level, or it may be at international level. So many policies and practices. For example, humne already dekha hai, there are so many laws. For example, EPA 1986 is there, Environment Protection Act 1986 is there, Air Prevention and Pollution Control 1981 is there, Water Act is there, Water Act 1974 is there, Biodiversity Conservation, Wildlife Conservation Act, Conservation Act 1972. Similarly, we have international initiatives to tackle or eradicate such problems like Kyoto Protocol, Montreal Protocol, Biodiversity Convention, and so many other initiatives has already been taken to tackle such environmental issues. Then, practices. What are the practices? Practices simply means if we are already formulated a policies for the issues already raised, then we are supposed to implement such policies on ground level, and this comes under the practical or portion of the issues. Means we have already laws, EPA is there, Air Act is there, Water Act is there, Biodiversity Conservation is there, CITES is there, Montreal Protocol is there, Kyoto Protocol is there. The Kyoto Protocol is for reduction of carbon, greenhouse emission, carbon emission, or Montreal Protocol for ozone layer depletion, ODS substance to reduce consumption and production. So, if we have already formulated policies and laws, now it becomes mandatory to implement these laws on ground level, be it at international level, be it at national level, state level, or district level, or the level, government level, as the case may be. So, environmental issues now simply means all those problems are being faced by government, faced by environment nowadays, be it any form. Air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, and so many other issues already discussed, and the policies, and what are the policies have already been formed to tackle such problems and to implement such policies which have already been formulated at state level, national level, or international level. Implementation of such policies on ground level comes under the practices of the issues. Now we will have a look what are the environmental issues. There are so many environmental issues. So many issues we are supposed to discuss. First ever issue of the environment is air pollution. Next issue is water pollution. Then we are facing issue of soil pollution. Then we are facing solid waste pollution. We are also facing the challenge of ozone layer depletion. At the same time, we are experiencing the challenge of climate change. Similarly, we are facing the challenge of acid rain, and we are to combat with the problems like natural disasters. Natural disasters and increase in greenhouse gases. These are, I mentioned here, some of the issues the environment is facing nowadays. So let us try to have a look on these issues. What are these? First is air pollution. Just we will have a look what is air pollution. Air, you know, is the combination of mixture of gases. It contains 78% of nitrogen, 21% of oxygen, carbon dioxide is there, krypton is there, xenon is there, and so many other gases are present in traces. So this constitutes our air, or we can say atmosphere. Then what is pollution? Pollution means presence of air pollution simply means presence of any solid, liquid or gaseous substance in the air in such concentration and for such duration which may be or tend to be injurious to plants, animals, human beings and property. So due to anthropogenic activities like industries, automobiles, combustion of fossil fuels in domestic purposes and deforestation and so many other anthropogenic activities results the menace or problem of air pollution. In the next lectures, we are supposed to discuss in detail what are air pollution, what are the causes, what are the consequences of air pollution, and what are the control measurements. So today we are only going to have a look, a general look on these environmental issues. Second one is water pollution. Water, you know, is also having three different properties. It is having three different properties. It is having physical property, chemical property, and it contains biological property. Physical property may be its color, turbidity, pH, conductivity, turbidity, color, odor, etc. And chemical properties like dissolved oxygen, fixed carbon dioxide, biological oxygen demand, COD, nitrates, phosphates, or ammonia present in the water. And biological properties are, what are the organisms present in the water? It may be pathogenic organisms like Salmonella typhi, Shigella dysentery, Entamoeba histolytica, and so many other pathogenic organisms may be. And it may also contain phytoplanktons, Cnidodesmas, Oscillatoria, and nectans in the form of fish, etc. Means water is having a particular physical, chemical, and biological properties. And presence of any particular organism in the water declares whether the water is polluted or clean in nature. Depending upon the physical properties of water, depending upon the chemical concentration present in the particular water body, and presence of the biological entity, which type of biological entity is present in that particular water body. On the basis of all these properties, we can declare whether the water is polluted or unpolluted. So, how we can define water pollution? Simply, we can define any undesirable change. I am emphasizing undesirable change. Undesirable change in physical, chemical and biological properties of water is simply known as water pollution. Means if the physical property has got changed undesirably, if the chemical property of the water has got changed undesirably, and if the biological property has got changed undesirably, then we can declare the water is polluted in nature. We don't have such criteria that we can declare the water on the basis of a single property whether the water is polluted or unpolluted. So next is soil pollution. If we discuss about the soil, soil is actually having five different components, it contains mineral matter, it contains organic matter, it contains flora fauna, it contains air, it contains water. These are the five basic components of a true soil. If all these components is possessed by any particular pedon, a lump of soil, then we can call this a true soil. Then how we can define soil pollution? It's so simple. Addition of any substance into the soil which is not the basic constituent of the soil, or loss of any basic constituent of the soil from the components. Simply, addition of any substance to the soil which is not the basic constituent of the soil can we call as soil pollution. Similarly, deletion of or loss of any basic constituent of soil, like loss of mineral matter, loss of organic matter, loss of air, water, loss of flora, fauna, etc. present in the soil, beneficial flora, fauna especially, then we can call this soil pollution. And if the soil has become polluted due to addition of any foreign substance like heavy metals, acids, alkalis, toxic substances, pesticides, fertilizers, etc. If addition changes the basic constituents of the soil, then we can call this positive soil pollution. And if we are losing some of the basic constituent of soil, maybe we are losing organic matter, mineral matter, microflora, fauna, air, water, then we call negative soil pollution. Loss of any basic constituent from the soil is also called pollution, but negative soil pollution. Positive soil pollution means if we are adding something which is not the basic constituent of the soil into the soil, then we can call this positive soil pollution. Then next we'll discuss solid waste pollution. Solid waste pollution. Nowadays, pollutants in the form of cardboards, plastics, cans, rakes, and so many other solid substances are being dumped in discarded from either from the houses or from the industries or from the commercial complexes. And all such substances which are solid in nature gets accumulated on a particular surface and becomes a pollutant, because such substances or such pollutants like cardboard, sticks, cans, bottles, plastics, etc. become a source of breeding ground for the mosquitoes, or become a source of pollutant, become a source of ground for the infectious diseases, because it provides a ground for the growth of many pathogenic organisms. Hope you got an overview of these issues. We'll discuss next issues on the next lecture. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Best of luck.